You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. Top story today, a Navy S-70C anti-submarine helicopter made a hard landing at Zuoying Naval Base yesterday, and all four crew members on board sustained injuries. The most seriously injured was the crew chief, who suffered burns to 95% of his body and is currently in ICU. The military has formed a task force to investigate and determine the cause of the incident.
The S-70C anti-submarine helicopter that made a hard landing at Zuoying Naval Base on June 22nd was still at the site where it crashed, although it was now covered by a tarp and surrounded by a blockade line. A military investigatory task force began investigating on June 23rd. On the afternoon of June 22nd, the helicopter was conducting training at the Naval Anti-Submarine Aviation Group's base when it suddenly dropped and made a hard landing within the base. Dense smoke poured out, which was noticed by nearby residents. There were four crew members on board and all sustained injuries. The pilot and co-pilot's vital signs are stable after receiving treatment. The crew chief sustained the most serious injuries, with second to third degree burns on 95% of his body. The military asked doctors specializing in burns and cardiologists to come to Kaohsiung to assist in the treatment of the crew chief.
全身2到3度的烧烫伤，面积达95%。 并且有蛛网膜下腔出血，那已经实施了清创，还有抗生素的治疗。
The Minister of National Defense said it will provide the best critical care to the patients. It also set up an investigatory task force to determine the reason for the accident. One possibility is that the tail rotor suddenly lost effectiveness. However, there was no mention of mechanical failure in the communication records.
The Navy S-70C helicopter crashed at Zuoying Naval Base yesterday, and according to media reports, the Navy did not report the accident immediately. The Ministry of National Defense wasn't aware that an accident had occurred until the Armed Forces Joint Operations Command Center performed an online search. The Navy responded that it reported the accident immediately in accordance with regulations.
太夸张了，十秒钟我立刻打电话就跟立刻给司令。我在昆明就是这样子。Former
Air Force Deputy Commander Zhang Yanting previously served as a superintendent of the Air Force Academy, and during that time there was an accident with a plane. Zhang said he reported the accident as soon as he was notified. A Navy S-70C helicopter crashed at Zuoying Naval Base on June 22nd. United Daily News reported that the helicopter crashed at 3:55 p.m. but the Navy didn't immediately report the accident. At 4:30 p.m., the Armed Forces Joint Operations Command Center searched online and found that there was a column of smoke ascending next to the base. It contacted the Navy at 5 p.m. to find out more, and it wasn't until after that, more than 1 hour after the accident, that the Ministry of National Defense became aware of the incident.
按照行政系统循序回报，所以五大系统啊。 那通通失灵了，那五大系统失灵的状况之下，那是非常严重的事情。那平常则已啊，打仗的时候不得了。Zhang
said it's impossible to conceal a major event like this, and commanding officers need to quickly report to their superiors. He thinks it's unreasonable that the MND didn't know until 1 hour later. A delay may have occurred because officers and soldiers feared they would get punished. Meanwhile, a legislator said the military needs to investigate thoroughly.
通报系统是否有延误，通报的内容是否有大事化小、小事化无的心态，这个部分我们也会要求军方单位要确实的查明。事件发生以后，本部依照规定，循系统向各级来实施回报，在这一部分，我们也会列入调查。The
Navy said it will investigate. Taiwan's S-70C helicopters have been in use for over 30 years. The military wanted to replace them with MH-60R anti-submarine helicopters purchased from the U.S., but the price tag was too high. When asked whether it will restart negotiations because of the accident, the Navy said it is aiming for a reliable anti-submarine aviation group that conforms to the requirements of defensive combat, and there are no issues with personnel.
We'll now bring you some top stories from around the nation. Prosecutors launched an investigation on 9 police officers suspected of taking bribes, issuing false tickets, and allowing the unregistered cars back on the road. Temperatures remain high due to a Pacific high pressure system. The Central Weather Bureau issued a high temperature warning for 11 counties and cities. The number of patients who suffer from stroke in Taiwan is growing by 30,000 to 50,000 a year. Doctors also believe that strokes are on the rise among younger adults. Taipei City Mayor Ko Wen-je replaced the double ninth cash gift of NT$1,500 to senior residents with other social benefits after taking office. In 2021, the Taipei City Council passed autonomous regulations on double ninth monetary gifts for senior citizens. The city government's request for reconsideration was unsuccessful, so it applied to the Executive Yuan to declare the regulations invalid. On June 22nd, the Executive Yuan sent letters to the City Council and city government saying the regulations do not contradict the Constitution and do not violate the Local Government Act or the Fiscal Discipline Law.
举债花冲凉敬老金也是很奇怪，每个人都要当圣诞老公公，问题是要钱呐，要找到钱呐，明年的预算相当难编的，因为我们那个通货膨胀哦，天哪，我现在说的工程款都要加，最少是加20%，所以其实财务相当困难的。The
city government will now have to set an amount for the gift in accordance with its financial situation. Deputy Mayor Vivian Huang says the city government will first discuss a range. It is currently preparing an estimate which will be calculated according to the annual income and expenditure. There are currently more than 8,000 cases of victims applying for compensation for rare vaccine adverse reactions. However, from last year to the end of May this year, only 610 cases have been reviewed. The New Power Party criticized the central government's review process for being too slow and too strict.
Ms. Lee, in her 40s, has only been able to rely on crutches to maintain her balance for the past year. She contracted Guillain-Barré syndrome after being vaccinated last June, which causes weakness in her limbs and nerve pain. She applied for vaccine relief in February this year. So far, the reply she received from the central government is that they are still reviewing her medical record with no conclusion in sight. There are about 8,000 applications across the country from victims like Ms. Lee, but only 610 applications were reviewed from September last year to May 26th this year. At this rate, it would take 4 years to finish reviewing all the applications. Ms. M, who was half paralyzed after receiving the BNT vaccine in October last year, does not even know her case number. She has also encountered obstacles in diagnosis and treatment. No representative from the Ministry of Health and Welfare was present at the meeting. They only offered a written response stating that applications will first be categorized. Death cases of those under the age of 60 and thrombosis cases with symptoms will be reviewed first. The frequency of review meetings has also been changed from once every 2 months to twice a month now. However, such a reply only made victims like Ms. Lee, who did not meet the qualifications for primary consideration, continue to wait with their aching bodies.
And now bringing some top stories from around the world. With gas prices hovering at about $5 a gallon, U.S. President Joe Biden is asking Congress to legislate a gas tax holiday, which would suspend a federal gas tax through September. Thousands of farmers gathered in central Netherlands Wednesday to protest against the Dutch government's plans to rein in emissions of nitrogen oxide and ammonia. Scientists are now investigating how blood splatter-like spots in snow could be connected to climate change. The reddish dots are made up of tiny algae that grow on snowy mountain ranges, which can fuel snow melt. A DUI incident happened in Elan yesterday. The car first hit a truck, flew up, and flipped over to the side of the road. One passerby was harmed and sustained head injuries. The driver had a blood alcohol content of 0.83%, and this wasn't her first time driving under the influence of alcohol.
A woman surnamed Tuong had just purchased some fruit and was walking next to a curb. Suddenly, a white car appeared, first hitting a parked pickup truck, then flying up and flipping over. Huang fell to the ground. Fortunately, she only sustained a bruise on her head and her life is not in danger. This incident occurred at 4:11 p.m. on June 22nd at the intersection of Sanxing Road Section 1 and Culling 5th Road in Elan's Sanxing Township. The person that caused the accident was a 25-year-old woman surnamed Yang, who was driving under the influence. Her blood alcohol concentration measured 0.83%. And she is being investigated for public endangerment. A witness said Yang was completely unaware that she had hit someone and she was getting her bag and preparing to leave on foot. Luckily, a nearby fruit vendor started berating her, causing her to stay at the scene. A police investigation found that this was not Yang's first DUI incident. She is unemployed and has previous convictions for public endangerment. She confessed that she drank alcohol and ate at a friend's house on June 22nd and claimed that she got behind the wheel to return the car to another friend she borrowed it from.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.
We'll be right back.